Here's an interesting organ or tissue. The upper part looks rather uniform and pale and not terribly cellular, very much like much a brain tissue usually does. The lower part, which is the majority of the tissue or the organ, looks very glandular. And not only does it look very glandular, but you could see some of these little nests of cells are rather bluish. Some are pinkish, like here. And some of them don't appear to have any color at all, like perhaps here and here and here with minimal cytoplasm. This is a pituitary gland. The upper part is the neurohypothalamus, the posterior pituitary with neural-like tissue. The bottom part, which is about 80-90% of the organ, is the adenohypothalamus, with your basophils appearing blue, eosinophils appearing pink, and chromophobes appearing colorless or chrome-less, or like they hate color, like chromophobes. In addition, even though we have some fairly decent histology here in this posterior in the anterior pituitary adenohypothalamus, there are areas that look like they are kind of necrotic, in which perhaps you don't see too much cellular detail at all. Perhaps there's some ingress of neutrophils as well. In addition, there are other fairly poorly defined zones in here, in which you have just a total outline of cells with not much nuclear detail, like coagulation necrosis. This is an infarct of the pituitary. For whatever reason, I don't particularly know, blood supply was cut off just to part of the pituitary. In fact, it's just a part of the adenohypothalamus. The neurohypothalamus looks fairly nice and neural, as it usually does. And I think possibly you might even see here a little bit of the intermediate lobe, which has these small follicles, very much looking like thyroid follicles. This demonstrates that when a pituitary is infarcted, besides having a necrotic inflammatory reaction, like you see in this purplish area down here, you also have coagulation necrosis, like you see here. That's all I want to say.